With Facebook facing fresh backlash for sharing people's personal information without their consent, these kids in California are reading the fine print.
Yeah, we've been learning about like privacy policies and terms of agreement.
It freaked you out?
Yeah.
You guys have friends in seventh grade, obviously, outside of this school and outside your class.
Yeah.
Do any of them read the terms of agreement on social media?
No.
But they admit they feel the pull.
Who texts?
Everybody
texts. Who FaceTimes?
FaceTime.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
And in this class, their devices aren't a distraction. They're their homework.
What is this homework assignment?
It's a digital diet.
Wait a minute, you guys made charts?
Yeah.
Olivia did a lot of sleeping, 12 hours.
Yeah.
That's good. How many hours a day were you using digital media?
Well, I was using 8 hours a day, which was pretty surprising to me.
So more than half of the hours you're awake, you're on digital media.
It was crazy.
It seems the phones so many of us hold have a hold over us.
12 and a half hours total.
Yeah, I was like, oh, I should probably actually do something.
Yeah. Their teacher, Diana Graber, did.
Think back to your previous digital diets.
Creating this class, now taught in 34 states.
You teach a class called Cyber Civics.
Yeah.
What is that?
Well, it's
turn off
the. It's learning how to use your devices respectfully.
And see that?
And thoughtfully.
There you go.
There's a class happening in a few hours.
Let's try that again.
When you walk around at the school here, do the kids look at you and say, "That's the teacher who wants to take away our phones"?
No. That's the teacher that lets us talk about our phones.
One in three kids uses a phone before they can talk. By the time they're teens, they're on it 11 hours a day. But are smartphones making us smarter? Think of it this way. This guy, the goldfish's attention span is only about 9 seconds. Since 2000, remember flip phones? The average human's attention span dropped from 12 to just 8 seconds. That's right, our attention span is now shorter than a goldfish's. And that's not all the science says.
Before, internet addicted, and look, pretty dramatic, right?
In this MRI machine, Dr. David Rosenberg, chief psychiatrist at Children's Hospital of Michigan, says he can see a difference.
Look at what's happening in the brain's arousal reward system.
Today, he's studying two triplets, Noah and Samantha. She, like most 14-year-olds, won't put her phone down. But the MRIs reveal only Noah is hooked.
He stopped playing Minecraft, but he's replaced it with Xbox.
But I'm more active now.
You're standing up and playing? What do you mean you're more active?
And the brain on games looks a lot like a brain on drugs.
They found ways, just like with nicotine and tobacco, to hook us.
Dr. Rosenberg recommends just 2 hours total of online time for teens.
And that assumes that all homework and chores have been completed.
Back at Journey School, students admit it's a process.
My project is music of the Renaissance. So I'm looking on YouTube, looking for the most popular songs. So then I get
Let me guess, when you're on YouTube, you're not always looking at music of the Renaissance videos.
And then something will pop up and be like,
all of a sudden you're listening to,
like, a banana song by the Minions.
A banana song by the Minions.
Oh, yeah.
Still, their teacher, Diana Graber, is optimistic.
I hope they go out there and that they use their devices in powerful, wonderful ways, the ways that, you know, a lot of us forget they're designed to do.
So holy moly, this stuff is no joke addictive, and there are lots of side effects, but there are a few simple things actually we can all do to keep kids safe in the digital world and enjoying life in the real world, which is also great. If you need your child to be in constant touch, start with an old school flip phone. Try to avoid phones, tablets, computer screens until they're 10 years old. Ask your school to do the same. Good luck. Parental controls are crucial. Most smartphones and even YouTube have ways to limit access to content, and then create tech-free zones for your family at home. As parents, you know, we have to keep up our end of the bargain.
As another
parent of a toddler, ain't so easy, right?
Yeah. 10 years old seems like a long time.
Yeah, really long time, doesn't it? But that's what they say. It's good luck, I guess.
But the max, the doc's saying, is 2 hours a day for your kid.
And
that's
these
what
kids are doing
limit.
Half the day, 12 hours
my
a day.
Gosh.
All their waking hours, more or less.
What are they doing online for 12 hours?
Yeah, that's a good question, Craig. I don't know.